Welcome to the show, and you're watching Urban Television here, right here. We on one-on-one, chilling at the Cup Kisementi, and my name is Anisha with the tea, your host. Now, today, we all know it's a beautiful Wednesday, a day that we get to celebrate women. Now, to actually, we got, should I call you a mother? You're a mother too? Oh, she looks disappointed. Let me take that one back.
Yeah.
She's a lady who's not been living in the country. She's been away. She's been living in the, she's still living in London, right? And she came back, unfortunately, to bury her mom. But even better, she's bringing some new technology that will be helping Ugandans who decide to invest in it. In the next 4 to 3 years, you'll be enjoying the fruits of your labor, I have to say. But let me give her a few minutes to introduce herself. Welcome to the show, my dear.
Thank you, Shina. My name is Roshida Kiggundu. Because I have got two different names. So people know me as Rose and the other know me
Why
as
do you
Roshina.
Have two different names?
Yeah, I was a Christian before, oh. But now I got married to a Muslim man. That's why my name's changed. Roshina from Rose.
Did you change because of the Muslim man, or you changed because you love the religion?
I have no issues with that religion because I grew up with Muslim countries. We're neighbors and I have no issues with it.
Okay.
Yeah, so getting married to someone that you love and who cares for you, and you know, you all believe in God, is something very amazing.
That's true.
I don't take that to be a problem.
Mm.
Yeah. So I'm very happy to be here on Urban TV. And the reason I'm in Uganda right now, because I came to bury my mom, my lovely mom, and she will always be missed. And she passed on the 11th of July, and we kept her for some time so that I can arrive. I've got my two other sisters who live in Belgium, Judith and Sarah, and we got to bury her on the 26th of July, and may her soul rest in peace.
Well, we're so sorry for your loss, Madame Roshida Kiggundu, but the fact that you are a lady who's been in and out of the country and you've lived in London for so long, that means you're very brave. We're not the kind of strong heart, because I hear so many stories, it's not easy to leave that side. But before we get into that, when did you decide to leave the country and move to London?
Actually, I've been in London since 2010. It's not long ago, but yeah. I left Uganda in 1999.
Wow.
Yeah. When I left Uganda, I lived in South Africa for 7 months. And then from South Africa, I used to live in Ethiopia. And in Ethiopia, I lived there for 4 years. From Ethiopia, I lived in South in America for 3 years as well. And from the USA, I went to Canada for another 1 year. I was doing the course... you know, with this basics of business management. And when I left Canada, came back to Uganda, I was in and out.
Yeah, because yeah. I was actually about to ask you, do you work for the UN? Did you have families? That's why you kept changing from Ethiopia to the United States. Do you, you know, that's a little bit confusing because it's either work or family.
It was regarding work, but we shouldn't go into that deeply. I can explain that later to you, maybe privately.
Privately, that's okay. That's good. That we have. So then now,
I left for the UK, so that's where I've been for, you know, since 2010.
Okay, yeah. That's where you got married from, too.
Yes.
Yeah? And you have children, you have a family.
I have no children.
Okay.
But I'm hoping to get one soon.
Amen. Now let's get into the fact that now you are in the UK and you're building on a project there. Yeah, you're starting up something that is also going to help Ugandans. How did you just wake up in the morning and read a book and go online and realize there's something, or someone approached you about this new technology and you're like, maybe I can take this back home and it can help people out there?
Yeah, regarding what I do now, I'm a consultant at this very project, Skyway String Technology. It's about public means of transport, and it's going to be global. It's not just in the Western world. And what we are doing, we are promoting the project to any other local person like me or you, whereby you get to become a co-owner of the technology, and you own it. I should say you own it if you become a supporter or you fund the technology itself. The reason we're doing this, because the inventor himself had this dream way back 1978, wow. and has been building this technology since that time. There are lots of different phases that I can show you later, not now.
Not now.
Yeah. So he's a big scientist and an engineer. He's based in Belarus, and he's been with the airspace shuttle programs as well. So he's not like a young scientist or who just, you know, doesn't. Person just came in today.
He's been in there, yeah.
Yeah, so he's been there for a long time. And you could see where the world is taking us in the next coming centuries or years. So he was trying to solve all these issues like we have today, challenges we face today, like traffic,
fuel prices.
Yeah, and he came up with an idea. Because we can see this happening in Uganda or in any other country. There's a lot of accidents, traffic, pollution, and also fares. People are paying really high to, you know, to get anywhere, like to go from country to country. Like going from Kampala to Nairobi, it's a lot of money. From, you know, Rwanda to Tanzania, or, you know, just name it.
Mm.
It's a lot of money. So with this technology, it's going to be very cheap, yeah, to travel, very friendly, eco-friendly, low noise. It's going to be from the ground. It's going to be elevated from the ground to the, you know, the above, from 10 meters and above, depending on the area.
Okay.
Because it can be built anywhere, in any kind of terrain, whether it is rocky or mountainous or swamp or, you know, any type of terrain.
Now, I've seen your passion and I'm very glad to hear this. I feel I'm already attached to it.
Yeah.
And I feel like this is something that we should invest in as a country, even individually. But I want to know how you got the link. You understand?
Yes.
Did you meet this man personally, the scientist, the engineer? Or was it a gentleman who came up to you? That's what I was asking you from the beginning. Did you go on the internet? Because when you're reading about this, I'm like, do I rest my MBs researching about the wrong things?
Yeah.
How did you get to find out this gorgeous technology that we could be using?
Like, you know, in London, everything is like digital. The world is moving digital. I met my friend Madalena, who is based in London, and she's right now in Belarus today, where the testing site for this wonderful technology is. Actually, this is the technology, if you can have a look at it.
Wow.
Yeah, that's how the trains are going to be running.
Mm.
So I met this amazing lady, and she introduced me to this project, and I actually started to work with them. So working with Skywhistle Technology, I've met lots of people from different walks of lives. But when she introduced me, I was kind of curious. But then she took me to the offices where they work in Old Street. But they moved now to a new office in Morgan. So working with them was very amazing. I was like, no, I have to take it to my country. And actually, I have been promoting it on Facebook. I'm very popular on Facebook. And you know, I've got some Ugandans in this country who have already invested, but they couldn't promote it. They wanted me to come on the ground and show them how to promote this great project. Because people sometimes think when you promote something and you get paid, because they have no office located in Uganda or in Tanzania, they think it's like this pyramid scheme.
Yes.
It's not a pyramid scheme. It's kind of a waterfall.
Mm.
Yeah. You can come into the company, decide to invest. Invest for your children, invest for your mom, for your brother, and leave it there. Or you can decide to take it as a business, and you also got education part of, you know, part of it in the project. They educate you about how to diversify your money.
You know, the question that most Ugandans will have is, when take a mood 10 million, when do I get it back? You get it? How do I get it back? Because it's putting in your money and you're just there, sitting like, okay, someone promises you 2-3 years, how sure are we? You know, because I know business is sketchy, but also people in Uganda, it's hard to get that money now. By the time you invest in it, people want to know, how do I get back my money? When do I get back my money? My profits?
Talk about getting back your money. Like I said, it's a long-term investment. And this platform called the crowdfunding platform, it was started in America by Barack Obama. He signed the bill in 2009. So that's the very platform we are using to promote the project. And being that it's a startup company, you don't get your dividends, I should say, now, if I got to do it today. You get it in the future because you are funding the technology to happen. We are making the technology to happen.
So when it starts...
It's not already running, but we are now under the phases of certification. So far, as I told you, They're in Paris today to see how the trains have been built. I was supposed to be there today, and lucky, like, you know, I was unlucky that my mom passed away. But the technology itself is currently being under testing, whereby after the testing, all the countries that have already signed up for the technology.
Has Uganda signed up?
Not yet, but Tanzania has.
Wow.
Addis Ababa is in the process, probably South Africa, and many more other countries. I have them on the list here. I can show them to you.
So at least we have two African countries signed up.
Yeah, we've got, as you can see, we've got Turkey, Australia,
Russia,
Tanzania,
yeah.
You've got Russia, you've got Ukraine, then Belarus itself, Ireland, India, Indonesia, Germany, many countries.
Many countries have signed up.
Measure them all.
Okay.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, we have to take a quick break. When we come back, we'll be talking about more of this. How we can sign up, you know, how you can take part of the project. That is if you want to be involved. Stay hooked.